Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Today in the oven, I have a pot roast going. And because of the flavors going on in the pot roast, I didn't want to cook the vegetables, the carrots, the onions, the potatoes, in with the pot roast. It's a barbecued flavored type deal. So I'm going to cook them separately. I'm going to do the carrots and the onions in their own wine and thyme braise. So this is a great braised carrot dish that you can serve with any meal. So I've got this pan hot. I'm getting it pretty high heat. I have some ghee here. You could use clarified butter. I'm just using ghee or clarified butter because the smoke point is pretty high and I want this to be hot. Maybe not that hot. Next in are the carrots. And I have a mix here of pearl onions and shallots. And I want to fry these just to get a little bit of color on the outside. And it's going to sputter and splatter. It's going to make a mess. If you just want to chuck everything around in the pan until you get a little bit of caramelization on the outside. Build some flavor. Okay, so while this is crackling away, I'm going to add a little bit of salt and pepper. And salt and pepper, always to taste. Put in the amount that you want. I'm going to put in about that much. And I think we're getting some nice browning. It doesn't take long to get some caramelization on the outside of the onions and carrots. So now I have a few sprigs of thyme. They're going to go in. And the braising liquid this time is going to be white wine. And if you don't want to use white wine, you don't have to use it. You could definitely just use chicken stock. And if I use chicken stock, I would put in a little bit of vinegar to keep the acidity up. Okay, so I'm going to put a lid on this, and this is where I stick it in the oven. This takes about a half an hour to braise at that lower temperature of 325 or so. So you put it in at the very end of whatever else you're cooking. Or if you're cooking a different kind of roast or turkey or something like that, and you're pulling it out during that rest time that the turkey is going through or the roast beef is going through, this can be popped in the oven and take advantage of that last 30 minutes while you're scrambling doing other things. And then you just forget about it. It's really easy. So into the oven we go. Hey, Jules.
Hey, Glen. Hey, friends.
So we're going to start with the carrot and onion dish, and then we'll move on to the other ones later. So this is just, it's just braised carrots and shallots with a little bit of thyme. Not anything too complicated, and it should just have the bright, fresh flavors of what's in there. It's a really simple.
So it's got a lovely little tang to the carrot.
Yeah. You get the onion flavor in the carrot. I don't think you'll get any carrot flavor in the onion. A little bit of thyme on top. And I mean, you could add other things to this. You could put garlic cloves in there if you wanted to.
Oh, yeah. Other root vegetables.
Parsnips.
Yeah.
Parsnips would go in there. Turnip would go in there. Rutabaga would go in there. You could really make it a braised root vegetable medley.
So this leads me to ask, other than the inclusion of the wine,
yes,
why not just throw it in the pot?
So the pot roast, I felt that the sauce that the pot roast was in would be too heavy and overpower the vegetables and we'd lose the flavor of the carrots and the onion.
Okay, so you have got a sauce that goes with your pot roast.
There's a sauce that goes with that.
There's a larger story.
So we've got a barbecue-flavored pot roast and a Marlboro apple pie, which is a shredded apple in custard.
Ooh, custard.
So come on back for those ones. And this is a simple, easy side dish that will go with any meal. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.